I've seen that a few scams went around recently that took advantage of folks not really knowing much about Ian Coleman's BIP39 tool that I've got here, and specifically not understanding really what they're looking at when they look at a tool like this. And the way that that caused people to lose their money is they didn't know what they could and couldn't share, and they also didn't really clearly know what they needed to back up. So that's what we're going to look at. This is what Ian Coleman's BIP39 tool looks like. If you just jump there on the web, I always recommend running this offline air-gapped in something like Tails Linux, and you can just download a standalone version of that. So what I've got here is a PDF where I've pretty much highlighted all the different areas and color-coded them. And what we're going to start with is red. That is, if the attacker has any of these five things, they can literally steal everything. The lot. Do not share these with anyone ever. Doesn't matter if you've got a hardware wallet or anything else like that, a customer support representative will never ask you for any of the information in these boxes. And if you have a hardware wallet, the wallet software you're using should not be asking you for this either. You should enter your 24-word seed once when you initialize the wallet, and that is it. Almost every other time that a wallet asks you for that is trying to rob you. So firstly, we've got the entropy and the filtered entropy. So these two things are basically the randomness that goes into making your 24-word seed. This raw binary is just a binary representation of these numbers, and the word indexes is just the BIP39 indexes for each word in the 24-word seed, because the 24-word seed words are actually made up of a list of words, and this is just their index in that list. So you've got your BIP39 mnemonic, which is your 24-word seed. I've also got your passphrase in there as well, because if you do have a passphrase, that gives you a bit more protection for this stuff, but still don't go giving it out. And you've also got the BIP39 seed. So all of these are essentially the same information being expressed in different ways. And again, if a hacker has it, they can get the lot. This is also a really important place to say that your BIP39 mnemonic plus the passphrase, if you have a passphrase, is the only backup you need at all ever. One of these scams that was going around was basically telling people they needed to keep their 24-word seed phrase, and they also needed to keep copies of like different bits of information from here, and the attacker was trying to be helpful in getting people to identify the different bits of information they needed to back up. No, this stuff, your 24-word seed, your BIP39 mnemonic, is the only backup you need, and it's the information from which everything else is derived. And you've got here, if you think about it, you know, your 24-word phrase is the only thing you actually entered into the website. So everything else has come out of it, even if you're maybe not clear on exactly how. So the next category of stuff that I've selected as orange. So if an attacker has this, they can steal all of the coins from one coin or one account. So for example, if you share this BIP32 root key, it means the attacker can steal everything that you have from the coin that you have selected at the time. So this is the piece of information that the scammers had people thinking they needed to back up in addition to what they had. Likewise, if you share your account extended private key or your BIP32 extended private key with people, they can steal from all of the addresses for the selected account for the coin that you have selected. So don't share that with anyone. From there, we move down to yellow. And the things that I've highlighted as yellow here are all of the private keys for individual addresses that you have. And what happens here is an attacker can steal all the coins from a specific address that they have the private key for, but only that address. So if someone had, say, this first private key here, that doesn't give them the ability to steal anything from any other addresses that you have. But still, don't share this with anyone. When Bitcoin Cash forked, and it happened in a really big way when Bitcoin Gold forked as well, you had the same set of private keys that now gave you two sets of coins. So people were encouraged to enter their private keys into these wallets to claim their new coin or their new forked coins. Now, the issue is that some people entered these private keys into scammy websites or scammy wallets, which stole their Bitcoin and left them with nothing. And what I will say here is, if you really must go entering in private keys to claim a fork, an airdrop, a blockchain snapshot, something like that. You know, move the original coins, like the main crypto that you're coming from, say Bitcoin, off that address first, especially if the fork has already happened, like with Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash. Though there are some things that can mean that this can sometimes have issues, and that is why hardware wallets will generally have official split tools for this. So once you get into the space of trying to claim forks and airdrops and all that with private keys, there are some ways you can lose your funds in that. So really pay very close attention to that and use the official tools if they exist. So those are all the different bits of information you shouldn't really have any reason to share with anybody ever. If in doubt, click that box, and if what someone's asking you for has disappeared, they probably shouldn't have it. I've highlighted these other bits of stuff that you can share with someone. They won't be able to steal your funds, but it may have privacy implications. So first of all, we've got the stuff that I've selected in brown, and this is your account extended public keys. And basically what happens if someone has these, they can identify all of the public addresses for the given coin. That's the coin that you had selected here, and the given account. You'll notice that every time you do receive in your wallet, it generates a new address, and it will be addresses sort of like in this order. And if someone has these XPub keys, they can see all of the addresses that will be generated when you go to receive coins. So there is one special case here which is worth mentioning, which is that if someone has your XPub key, and one of the private keys associated with that XPub key, they can actually then access all of the private keys for that account only. So it's not as bad as sharing, say, your 24-word seed or something like that, but it's important to understand when you're giving out your XPub key that if someone happens to get one of the private keys associated with that, they can then access all of the private keys for that account. Only share this with apps you trust. So, you know, there are some watch-only wallets that allow you to see and receive Bitcoin at these addresses and use your XPub for that. But don't just share it with random people. There's no reason anyone should need this information from you. That brings us to the last things, the stuff that I've highlighted in blue, and that is the things that are safe to share. So your public addresses and even your public keys that go with your public addresses are safe to share. You know, these addresses can't actually be linked to each other except through analysis of your transactions. So someone can just have one public address, and that doesn't mean that they can automatically see all of the others. It doesn't mean they can steal your funds or anything like that. And you can be free to share those with anyone. Though the thing I would say is if you do have individual addresses that might have large amounts of funds in them and you don't want everyone to know, I guess, exactly how much you're worth, then you might not want to share those specific addresses with people or addresses that are linked to them that you've either moved money in or out of. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Just hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make to help people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. Or if there's a question you'd like some more information about, or a topic you'd like me to cover in the future, just leave a reply.